Hello, good morning. It's a beautiful day. The sun is shining. A great day to work outside. As you can see, I put my old rags on, so now I can do some working on cars. I have this Peugeot 307cc, a convertible, which I have sold, and it's scheduled for a delivery today. So the last thing I need to do is to get an oil change for it. I thought about doing it myself this time and show you how it's done. So let's get started. To perform an oil change, you need, of course, oil. For this car, Peugeot is advising 5W40, so that's what I bought. Again, I bought Valvoline. Cheap branded oil, branded oil is always a good thing. It will also require an oil filter. In this case, it's a Bosch filter. And you need a little ring, because when you take out the drain plug, you need to put a new ring behind. Let's open it up. Before changing the oil, it's best to warm up the engine. I kept the engine running just now for a little bit, so the engine is up to temperature. Another thing which I've done, I put it on small tiny stands. That gives me a little bit more room to work under the car, and it's still really safe. I would advise not putting it too high, because then you can't drain all the oil, but a little bit like this should be okay. The drain plug is under the car. I'll try to squeeze under and show it. My camera stand is a bit too high. This is the drain plug for the engine oil. That one need to be loosened. I'll see if I can squeeze the camera in under here, but it's gonna be tight. I'll try to show you as much as possible. Just like the previous time with the motorbike, also over here is the advice: put a little bit of cardboard under it. Then at least you won't ruin your driveway if something goes wrong. Open now. Make sure you put the bin far enough away, because when the oil starts flowing, it will reach further than you think. Also, if you're really good, you can do it without losing the drain plug. Which I managed. As you can see, it's the oil drain is only dripping a bit. For me, this is sufficient for now, so I'm gonna put the drain plug back in, because I need my bucket for something else. Don't forget to put a new O-ring on your drain plug. And always first put it in with the hands before you tighten it, because if you put it in with tools right away and it didn't go in straight, you might ruin the plug. You you want to tighten it a little bit, but not too much, because you don't want to damage it. So I've taken a small ratchet. And because you tighten it, the O-ring will get smashed, and that will make for a tight connection. Okay, that's it. Clean it once more. And then as of now, there should be no oil coming out of there anymore. To be able to remove the filter, it's all too tight and too dark under there to show you. So I'm just going to show you like this. The air filter of the oil filter is hanging like this. To get it out, you need to put an oil filter wrench on it. Like this, tighten the screw, and then you can take it out. You should put it counterclockwise to remove it, clockwise to tighten, counterclockwise to remove. So you just tighten it like that, release it like that, open it again, put it a little bit further, and again, just as far until you can take it out. The old oil filter is out. This is the new oil filter. We need to put some oil in there first, because otherwise it takes some more time for the engine to get oil everywhere. Like I showed before, 5W40 oil. Just a tiny little hole. It doesn't need to be completely full, because that's more difficult to put it on. The rubber ring over here needs to be looped a little bit. I spilled some oil, so I can use that to make sure that the whole ring is looped properly. Now what I need to do is I need to put the oil filter on. It's under the car again, so it's too difficult to show. So just take my word for it, screw it on like that. The oil filter is on. So the next thing to do is put some oil in the engine. Apparently it runs better with oil. This car needs 4.2 liters, so I'm gonna pour four bottles of these in there, and then I'm gonna run the engine for a few seconds to see how the oil level is doing. If you don't have a steady hand, then better don't do it like this. But I think I can do it. A little trick to make the pouring a little bit easier. If you pour the bottle like this, then you only have the oil will come pouring out right away. If you put it like this, it will be a little bit easier. It will be a little bit easier to do it by hand. This is just to check whether there's sufficient oil in there to run the engine. Because in case I messed up and it needs 20 liters of oil, better be safe than sorry. There is oil in there. At the moment it's at the maximum level over here. Usually the difference between minimum, the little gap over here, and maximum, the gap over here, is usually about 1 liter. But this is fine. So now I'm gonna run the engine. When I start the engine, it is quite normal that the oil light will turn on for about 5 seconds. This is enough. We're gonna wait a minute, and then we're gonna check the oil level.
And probably we have to pour about 0.2 liters of video load. Okay, the engine has been running just now and I let it stand for 1 or 2 minutes. So now I'm checking the oil again, see how the level is. First clean it, put it back in, wait a sec, take it out, and then you can read the oil level. And it is just below maximum. See, the level comes to here, which is perfectly fine. Okay, the car has received the service now, so I need to reset the service check light. If I turn it on now, it shows minus 5,200 kilometer, meaning service is 5,200 kilometers past due. To reset it on a Peugeot 307 is actually quite easy. Push the reset button, turn the ignition on, and wait for about 5 seconds. I will show you. One more. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And it's reset. Let's check the results. 30,000 kilometers, perfect. That's it. That's how you change the engine and oil on a car. Hope to see you again next time. And if you like my videos, you can subscribe. That will motivate me to make more videos like these. Thanks a lot. Bye bye.